is for you, man. Tell your people. He said he's going to speak to them about chaos. And you're going to let them know that they may feel that I am far in the chaos, but I am there in the chaos. Amen. I am there in the chaos. See, he took me to Genesis 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the earth. Now there was chaos. In the beginning, there was chaos. In the beginning, there was chaos. I'm going to say it again. Turn to somebody next to you and tell them, in the beginning, there was chaos. And he was a Trinity, because remember, when you go out for Faramutira Messiah, I feel his presence, oh my God. When you go, oh, Rabashanda Lavakaya, when you go forth in the rest of the chapter, my, hallelujah, I worship you, King of Glory. The Trinity was there. The Trinity, the three of them. You will see how they're speaking, because you go further down, as you continue reading Genesis, you will see the whole creation bit, how he said, let us make man in our image, let us. So the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit were there. I want to let you know that in the chaos, they're there. They're there. You may think God cannot abide in the chaos. God cannot abide in this messy room. God cannot abide in this mess I'm in. God cannot abide in this messy pain. God cannot abide in this messy circumstance. But he wants me to tell you today. I didn't have a chance to study and prepare because he wanted it to be a direct line, an instant direct line from him to you. Hallelujah. That he, hallelujah, abides in the midst of your chaos. Like in the beginning when he created the heavens and the earth, everything was chaotic, everything had no form, everything was empty, everything was a mess, everything was turned upside down. Hallelujah. Oh, but he wants you to know, oh my God, this is a direct line from heaven. These are not even notes. I might have just a couple things in front of me, but these are not even notes, my God. He wants you to say, say it again. God is in the chaos. Oh, Ramatuta Lamasaya. Why? Because he's making assessment. Oh, hallelujah. He's making assessment. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Mandalaya. Metere Babashuta. He's making assessment in that chaos like he did in the beginning of Genesis chapter 1. He is making assessment. Oh, Aramaya Masi. Oh, my God. And when he made assessment, I can imagine, oh, him, Trinity, oh, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. There he said, let there be light. And there was light. And in that chaos that you may be in right now, you may feel that you're lost in the dark. You may feel you're in a dark place. Oh, hallelujah. You may feel you're in this agonizing pain. Hallelujah. You may feel that the light is not showing the way through the tunnel. You say there's no light at the end of this thing. You may feel like what in the world happened? It was just sunny and beautiful, and there were daisies and tulips and birds and sparrows and all this stuff around me, squirrels climbing the trees, and all of a sudden there's chaos. There's chaos in my life. There's chaos in my heart. There's chaos in my community. There's chaos in the world. What the in the happened? But God is saying, I'm there. I'm there, and I have the power to say, let there be light.
Hey, this is Pastor Jeannie Santos. Thank you for your subscription to my YouTube channel. And for the full message, go on Spotify or Anchor FM. Besos y hugs.